Hi, welcome back to The Shtick. We're still in the studio with Josh Burns.
It's good to be here, Henry.
A prospective Member of Parliament.
Indeed, indeed.
So when do you think next election, is it going to be called soon because of the mess we've created?
Last week when it was all going down in Canberra, we were planning for an October election. We were planning for the worst. But I think Morrison has to try and go for as long as he can. I think he has to try and go
to regroup.
Oh, they're just in shambles at the moment. So he needs to probably get to Christmas and hope everyone doesn't pay any attention over Christmas holidays and over the New Year holidays. But it was an extraordinary week in politics last week. We saw a really popular Prime Minister be completely shut down. And one of the things I think is amazing is that for every time that we've done this in the last 6 years, and of course the Labor Party has its history as well, is that there was always a political rationale to it, whether it was a bump in the polls to give them more of a chance to win the election or to save some of the seats. It sort of made sense, whereas last week seems to be as much about ideology and zealotry. And it was extraordinary for the Liberal Party to tear themselves apart. But on Thursday at 12 o'clock, every member of the Liberal Party and the National Party voted to shut down the Parliament because they had to sort out their own party issues. And at that point, they made a decision to say, we're not going to govern for Australia, we've got to fix our own problems. And I think they need to be held accountable for that. Mm. There's too many things and too many issues that are happening around Australia that the government needs to address, and they were missing.
Well, you said Turnbull was popular, but unfortunately, I think he let a lot of people down. He was really beholden after he'd taken power. Mm. He was still beholden to Dutton and Abbott and all his cronies, who are the conservative hard right of politics, and he could never really put his centre-right policies in. You know, he was too far centre for these people who just couldn't handle that his energy policies and some of his other policies that were just not acceptable.
Well, I think if you remember the marriage equality debate, you know, mm. Turnbull obviously supported marriage equality but wasn't willing to stand up to the party and bring and on did, some legislation.
And did a plebiscite.
And which, did Peter Dutton's plebiscite. And then and then again last week, Josh Frydenberg had worked pretty hard on the national energy guarantee, and it was Dutton and the far right of the party that said no. And instead of showing the fight that he showed in his last press conference, mm. where he threw doubt over Peter Dutton's candidacy, he buckled. And I think everyone breathed a sigh of relief when Malcolm Turnbull took over the prime ministership from Tony Abbott. But unfortunately, we haven't seen Malcolm show his fight that we all thought he had. So now it's over to Scott Morrison, who on a number of occasions hasn't been a friend of the working people, and on a number of occasions has preferred to prioritise big corporations and fought the Banking Royal Commission at every stage. He's got a big test, and I think the country is probably ready for a change in government.
Mm. And he's got a refugee issue as well, because he was the man who instituted Stop the Boats, which is a really good policy if we're doing that. But at the same time, they set up all these Manus Island detention centres, which is not really popular at all.
No, I think the way in which Scott Morrison transformed the Department of Immigration and Citizenship into the Department of Immigration and Border Security shows how he liked to use the political debate and the political issue to bring it to the right. I think it's time for a bit more of a compassionate voice on those issues, and I think it's time that we especially with children, that we look after people.
Out.
Yeah,
we've got Josh Frydenberg now one heartbeat away from being the Prime Minister. Now, that's really interesting how he's just in quite a short time. He's only 47 years old, and he is now.
He was the one guy who was beaming when he came out of that party room meeting. Yeah,
I know. Despite his... He has been very supportive of Abbott in the time that Abbott was in. Mm. He was very supportive of Turnbull, as was Julie Bishop. Now, there is a certain amount of allegiance within the Liberal Party. They are really solid and tight. when they come together. But last week's event just completely blew that whole image, that visage that they put up, apart.
I'm happy for Josh. You know, he's obviously...
Yeah, mazel tov, Josh.
He's obviously done very well, but... Yeah, at the end of the day, this is not about Josh Frydenberg. It's not about Scott Morrison. In fact, it's not even about Bill Shorten. It's about the Australian people, and it's about what the government's doing for Australian people. And it doesn't matter who's in a deputy. No one cares who's in a deputy leadership position. It's about what are you doing for Australian people. And we saw a government that lost its way last week. And as much as I'm happy for Josh, and it's good that a fellow traveller's in a good position.
A tribesman.
It's not really about us. It's not really about the politicians. And as soon as you forget that, then you see what happens last week is exactly what will transpire, and it's not good enough.
No, well, Turnbull has now retired from, is going to set up a situation where there'll be a real flux in Parliament. So there's, again, we can't govern. The government can't govern because until Wentworth is sorted, because he had a really good majority there, which is going to be whittled away because he's not going to be standing in the seat.
It'll be an interesting seat to watch. I think it'll be a hard seat for Labor to win, but who knows? You know, it'll be a good test of the damage that the Liberal Party has done in getting rid of a popular guy as the Prime Minister. Plus, I think he had a good personal following from what I can see in Wentworth. So, yeah, it's another sign of the madness of what they did last week. It was truly unbelievable, but. That's history.
And in that vein, we'll say goodbye to you now, Josh.
It's
thanks
great to be here,
Henry. Coming.
No worries.
And when the elections are rolling and when we know when the elections are on, we'll have you back.
I'd be happy to come back anytime.
Thanks so much. And we'll be back in the next segment with Julie Zigo, who's going to be talking to us about journalism, fake news, and what is going on in the world.